Nowadays, existence of integrated circuits, in short ICs, are widely used in order to make our daily life easier. But there is one which is most widely used of all the time, so-called 555 timer IC. In this tutorial, you will learn about the working of 555 in a stable multivibrator mode. Before going much more detail into this tutorial, I will suggest you to watch my video of introduction to 555 or basics of 555. Let us see the configuration of 555 in a stable multivibrator mode, and further we will see the working of 555 in a stable multivibrator mode. This is the block diagram of 555 timer IC. Here we have a battery whose value ranges from 5 volt to 18 volt, and somewhere it is mentioned 5 volt to 15 volt. Connect pin number 1, that is ground pin of 555, to ground of battery, and VCC, that is pin number 8, to positive terminal of battery. Now sort pin number 2 and 6. Now connect a LED to pin number 3 and ground. Now connect pin number 4, that is reset pin of 555, to VCC. Connect a capacitor of 10 nanofarad between pin number 5 and ground. Connect a resistance between pin number 7 and 8 and let it be R1. Now connect a capacitor between pin number 6 and ground. In the figure, by mistake, it is connected between pin number 7 and ground, and let it be C1. Now connect a variable resistance between pin number 6 and 7 and let it be R2. Now let us see the working of 555 in a stable multivibrator mode. Initially, this capacitor is discharged and starts charging. When initially power is turned on, capacitor is discharged and starts charging. During this, trigger pin voltage is below VCC by 3, and that makes the lower comparator, that is comparator 1, output high and sets the flip-flop and output of 555 chip is high, and the LED will turn on. This makes the transistor Q1 off, because Q1 is 0 and it is directly applied to the base of transistor. As the transistor is off, capacitor C1 starts charging, and when it gets charged to a voltage above the VCC by 3, then the comparator C1 output becomes low and the flip-flop output remains the same as previous. Now when the capacitor is charged above the 2/3 VCC, then the voltage of non-inverting end becomes higher than the inverting end of the comparator C2. Makes the comparator C2 output high and reset the flip-flop, and output of 555 chip becomes low, and the LED will turn off for time T2. This whole process is going to repeat after a time period of T, and the time period T is T1 plus T2. From T1 and T2 we can calculate the time period, and from time period we can calculate the frequency, which is 1 upon time period. Now let us see the practical demonstration of 555 in a stable mode. This is the circuit diagram of 555 in a stable multivibrator mode. Here R1 is equal to 10 kilo ohm, R2 is variable resistor of 10 kilo ohm, capacitor C1 is 47 microfarad 63 volt. This whole row is positive and this whole row is negative. First connect pin number 8 of 555 to VCC and pin number 1 to ground. Now short pin number 2 and 6. This gray wire is connected between pin number 2 and 6. Now connect the LED to pin number 3 and ground in series of 100 ohm resistance. Now connect the fourth pin of 555 to VCC. Connect a capacitor of 10 nanofarad between pin number 5 and ground. Now connect a capacitor of 47 microfarad 63 volt between pin number 6 and ground. Connect a resistance between pin number 7 and 8 of 10 kilo ohm. Now connect a variable resistance between pin number 6 and 7 of 10 kilo ohm. This 10 kilo ohm variable resistor is connected between pin number 6 and 7. Connect a 9 volt battery to the circuit. Now it's time to test the module. You will observe that LED turns on and turns off at time period of T, which is equal to 0.693 into R1 plus 2 R2 into C1. From this a stable multivibrator mode of 555, you can generate a square wave pulse. Or I can on this, that is a stable multivibrator mode of 555, you can generate a clock pulse for your counter circuits. Feel free to ask any questions in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned something new. If so, don't forget to like, subscribe and share this with your friends.